two sites at farmers' fields that had been burned down once and was not successfully controlled, and we went in there to treat it on, say, 12 to 15 inch tall marestail that had already, that was, a lot of it was branching out, and you know what it looks like when it's been hurt once and all of that. So two sites of that. And then at the same time, I said, well, it would be good to go ahead and do that on marestail that has not been treated yet. And so we had two different sites where the marestail was that tall at application, right? You know, about waist high or whatever in most cases. And so that's what you see on page 26 to 27. And it really didn't work out the way I, my theory was that once marestail has been hurt, it can be very difficult to control with a translocating herbicide like glyphosate. And I think that is true, and I think this shows that to some extent. And so my recommendations often are for a burning type product on marestail, like Ermoxone, or like Sharpen, after it's been treated once and not died. And so I didn't think that holds true. But what you can really see out of this data, if you're not familiar with what box and whisker graphs are, I like them when you're showing multiple sites or multiple years of data, because it shows you the variability in the data, okay? So the length of the box is how much variation there is across those two trials for that one particular treatment. So for example, I'll pick one of the biggest boxes on page 26. 3 pints of Gramoxone by itself on marestail that had not been previously treated, and we just went out there and sprayed waist tall marestail. I would not recommend that treatment. For one thing, it is extremely variable, but it needs something with it, okay? So we had all these combinations. Basically, we had Liberty, Roundup, and Gramoxone as the base treatments, and we sprayed those with either Sharpen, 2,4-D, dicamba, or first rate, all these things you might consider as options for marestail. So you see the data there for yourself on marestail that was not previous treated. This is one of those sites. There's an untreated control down there. You kind of see what has happened there. And actually, an untreated control is not, it's a kind of a misnomer, because that's been sprayed with Roundup. This whole trial has been sprayed with Roundup. We have glyphosate-resistant marestail here as well. It did set it back a little bit, as you can see. But for the most part, we got really good control of a lot of our treatments out here. But if you turn the page to page 27, control of marestail that was previously treated, I guess the lesson I've learned is that it is much easier to control than what I had thought. I thought that it would be just as difficult, if not more so, and that's not what we saw. We basically saw that, you know, waiting until marestail's way too big and trying to kill it with some of these products is definitely more challenging than going back in there and trying to burn something down that's already been hit once. You see all these bars at the top of the graph there, and no real boxes. That means there is no variability. That means they're all 100% across the top up there. So you have a lot of options with a lot of products. I think the environment probably had something to do with the reason that it lived through the first application, and it probably had something to do with the fact that we got pretty good control the second time around. But you know, every year I get asked, what's the explanation for why I don't kill marestail when I sprayed it at a pretty timely size, and they list off the treatments, and I would say, well, that's a good treatment, And so there's a lot of years where I don't have an explanation of why you didn't get control, other than just the environment and weather experienced at the time. You know, it's a tough weed.
If you're really challenged with marestail and it's a really bad situation, tough like this tall and just loaded everywhere, then I also mention things like if you're gonna do Roundup, if that's you're gonna be your base, then do a Roundup Sharpen 2,4-D or a Roundup Sharpen Clarity. Put them all together. Whereas I didn't really include that treatment in here because it just got too complex and everything. But but those tend to be the ones that actually work. It's costly, but it really will take down a really bad water marestail situation.